Hello, I'm Mike, and this is AskTractorMike.com. There's nothing any more frustrating than to get off work, ready to come home and get some work done on the farm. You back your tractor up to your implement, and you can't get your PTO to go on the tractor. And it's not all that uncommon a problem. If you're watching this video and you've experienced that problem, first off, I'm going to tell you what's going on inside that PTO connector, and then I'm going to tell you, hopefully, how to fix it. First off, let's explain how these things work. On every connection on the implement side that goes on the stub shaft of the tractor, there is a mechanism that releases either a bar or some ball bearings to go on the PTO, the splined PTO shaft on the tractor, and then release and lock in place. If you look on your stub shaft on the back of your tractor, you'll see there's a little groove there about halfway in. And that little groove is to allow either the bar or the ball bearings to go over that and connect the PTO shaft on the tractor so it does not come loose. So let's analyze the three different types of connections that I know of that are common to most attachments. The first one is a bar. And what it is a bar with a spring on it. It has a gap about halfway in it. When you push that bar through the PTO, you'll see there's that gap. What you do is you push that bar through, allowing that gap to slide on the tractor, and then you leave it and pull back, and when it locks in place, it's on there good. Now, if you've got this kind and the bar won't push in, that's your problem. Shoot a whole bunch of penetrating oil down there and take a ball peen hammer and you'll eventually get it loose. The other two forms are ball bearings. And the first one is a collar that you pull out, and it allows ball bearings inside the PTO coupler to release and go out away from the inside of the coupler. And they slide over the PTO, and then when you release that, the springs release, and when you pull it back, it locks in place, and it locks those balls in that groove in the PTO shaft on the tractor. The second form, and I actually prefer this, and you don't see it on too many implements, is a twist type, where you twist a collar that is threaded. It comes forward or backward if it's designed that way and allows the balls inside to release. That slides on the stub shaft of the tractor. You release it, a spring pulls it back, and then you slide it back and it locks in place. If that PTO shaft is one of the latter two designs and it won't go on, you have frozen balls, and frozen balls can be repaired. What's happened, and especially if you leave your implement outside all winter, you've got a little water in those ball bearings and it's rusted up. What you need to do is squirt a bunch of penetrating oil down there and keep trying to put that on the tractor. If you keep trying it, eventually it will go on, and you just got to keep the penetrating oil going and keep trying to slide the PTO shaft on the tractor stub shaft. It'll eventually go on. If it won't, you'll have to take the entire thing off and take it to your dealer, and it can be done just by sliding it off the end and take it to your dealer. He may have to eat it up or something, but you can get it loose. Now, I'm going to show you one thing I ran into one time. Some of these PTO shafts are a little misleading in how they attach on the tractor. This particular one is on a bush hog, and I've got a good friend that was trying to attach a bush hog on his tractor, couldn't get it on. He called me, and I went over, and he had squirted penetrating oil on it. He'd hit it with a hammer. He'd done everything I would have done. He was sliding the collar forward to try to get it on. Well, I came over, pulled it back. It looked like it went forward. It looked like that released the balls. It did not. So he was pushing against those ball bearings. When you pull the collar back, it slid right on. So make sure that's not your problem as well. Good luck.